Welcome to Vits-ing the Movies. I'm your host, Vits.
And I'm Tyrone, the Vader and the Optimistic Critic.
Trojan War, La Guerra por un Troyano, Safe Sex, starring Will Friedle as the guy who goes to a Trojan War. The title of this review will be Boy Meets Super Bad World.
Take me now, Brad. Brad.
Brad! Mr. Kimball.
Bits? What is this? It looks like a teen romantic comedy. Where are the great soldiers?
Oh, I think you got confused because of the title. It refers to the brand of condoms.
What? I can't believe it. This is one of the worst examples of clickbait I've ever seen.
I think you're overreacting. The title is meant to be just wordplay.
It doesn't even matter, it's a joke. The title is supposed to reflect what a movie is about. Imagine a person who goes to the cinema and reads the title on the list on the showings. Without even looking at the poster, they will assume it's about epic battles. I want the surprise to leave the movie lost money.
Now that you mention it...
What? How much money did it make?
300.
Really? It was a hit?
Not 300 million. $300. Yes, it's one of the biggest box office flops of all time.
That's weird. I have never heard of it before you invite me. A negative box office performance becomes news. That's how I know about March Needs Moms, 47 Running, Cat on Rhode Island, etc.
That's because those movies had big budgets and they were meant to be blockbusters. This one only cost around 15 million and this genre wasn't that profitable back then. Best case scenario, 80 million gross. Well, assuming that they had given the movie a wide release.
Why? In how many places did they show it?
One.
One what? One state, one city, one neighborhood?
One cinema. For 1 week.
I can't believe it.
But you know what? Let's put all that aside for now. We should judge the movie on its own merits.
I agree.
And on that note, we shouldn't blame whoever decided to cast Danny Masterson to play this role.
Hola, mamacita. Donde esta casa le Pepe?
Gotta give him a little romance, a little mystery. Gotta sell him the myth before you dive in on the fluff.
They didn't know.
Rod? It's Brad. School's over next week, and I'm so not passing biology. Will you tutor me, Brent?
It's Brad, you mindless...
You know, I would be honored.
What? Brad is looking at the camera? So that's supposed to be Brooke's point of view? Then why is Leah looking somewhere else?
You know, she totally knows all the way, right?
How would you know?
She's got the hair color, giggle factor, invisible panty line. Trust me, I know.
Is it just you three, or is your entire gender completely mental?
Hey, hey, hey! Not all the men are stupid.
Now we get a scene where Brad wants to practice what he'll say to Brooke by asking Leah to pretend to be her. And Leah gets so caught up in the moment that she reacts like Brad was talking about her. You all know this scene because we've seen it in other movies and TV shows. The reason why it doesn't work here, though, is because Brad describes specific things about Brooke.
Blizzard blue. That was my favorite color in the world. And until tonight, I didn't know why. It's the very color of your eyes.
My eyes?
Okay, why would Leah, who has brown eyes, be charmed by this?
Huh? That was pretty good, huh?
Oh no. Jennifer Love Hewitt's character is in love with a boy who chasing after another girl. You know what it means, Bits?
Yes, it means that it's a party of three.
No! It means that even though we are only 15 minutes, the conclusion is obviously very easy to predict.
All a girl wants is a little romance. To be swept off her feet. I mean, is that so much to ask?
If we were together, I'd treat you like a queen.
Do you have, you know, protection?
Yeah, just give me, like, a couple seconds. Perfect. 5 minutes, tops.
Leon, can I get a price check of 12-pack of Trojan prophylactics?
What's a prophylactic? Can I have one, too?
No, I said no.
I need a prophylactic. I have to have a prophylactic. Give me a prophylactic.
Noah, please behave yourself.
Grace,
you know
is that Jumbo or Pee-wee?
Of course, the good old gag about the cashier who announces something embarrassing. However, it makes no sense here. Look at what Brad did when he arrived.
Condoms. 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 Where are the condoms?
Condoms. Oh, pregnant. Where are they? Where are they?
Clearly, he's not ashamed that others will find out what he wants to buy. So why is he ashamed here?
Okay, I left my wallet in the car. I'll be back in like 1 second.
How you guys think Brad's doing with old Brookie?
Well, if he's attempting the old sexual predator Kyle monster thing, he's sunk. If he's doing a Brad, he'll be just fine.
They didn't know. They couldn't know.
You know, Seth and Josh aren't exactly the same characters. They contribute to the plot equally. One don't convince you into one person. Having two of the them feels pointless.
Spoiler alert.
Hello?
Leah, need your help.
Brad?
What? What's wrong?
Okay, I'm in a bit of a jam here. I need you to come pick me up now. I'm gonna hop on a bus. I'll meet you halfway. Like the corner of Fifth
and Receipt. Is that okay?
God, you know what? Actually, I don't have any money. No. I had my wallet.
Can I just tell you something? Every single day, you just make me stop.
First time.
Then you hop on. You just get me on the fare. Huh?
See, I've never actually been on
it. What's the salary? Exactly. Oh, 65 cents, right?
An offer, girly girl. Oh, God. Oh, Leah to the rescue to help with Brooke. Oh.
Wait a minute, how did Brad know it was Leah before the two vehicles lined up? Did he look at the type of car and guessed? Okay. She's the only person in this entire city with that car? Even so, with all this commotion, how can he pay attention to what's going on outside? And how convenient that the bus driver slowed down in this very moment.
Next time, maybe you remember! No free rides!
Hey, Mr. Driver. You did give him a free ride. You don't know where Brad lives. For all you know, you're leaving him closer to his destination compared to where he was before.
Hola. Wow, what a great place you guys have here.
You know, if I was Brad, I would be surprised that the music stopped like that all of a sudden. Also, how can people tell that he's white considering the lighting of this place?
A payphone somewhere nearby, I could use in a bit of a jam. Wait a second! Actually, I know how to say this sentence in Spanish.
Dude, when someone is standing in front of you with a gun, you don't make sudden movements.
Yo me che tu novia, tu hermana, tu madre.
What's the matter? I mispronounced it.
No, you didn't mispronounce it. The problem is that the subtitles say wife, but novia means girlfriend.
My sister says that you look like that guy in Baywatch. ¿Cómo se llama?
Camina solo.
That's her favorite show, man.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Me too. Vale conmigo, churro.
My little sister says that she wants to dance with you the salsa contest.
Hey. No one makes me feel the way you look.
Whoa! What just happened? She was already sitting down. How did she fly to the other table like that?
Man, you must do a carena with you!
Vamos, señor,
Just 5 minutes with Brock!
What?
Just 5 minutes with Brock!
Is it me or did he say Brock? I think he has spent too much time with Spanish speakers because he forgot how to pronounce in English. Although, if you read the name Brooke with the Spanish phonetic rules, it wouldn't be Brock, it would be Broke. Oh man! Brad is such a screw up that he can't even make a mistake correctly!
Brad?
Oh, it's so good to see you. Okay, let's go.
Brad, where's your dad's car?
You know, Leah, at some point in the future we can have this discussion, but now is it's really not the time, so if you can please just get me back to Brooks.
Fine, whatever.
Oh, I guess Brooke has psychic powers because she knew that Brad would somehow enter her room. She even left all the lights on for him.
Obviously, the cops are going to share the answers. They can possibly be that stupid. Oh, never mind.
So? Huh? How's it look?
Dude, you have breasts.
I'm sorry, does Leah wear a jacket literally every day? I can understand her not wearing something with cleavage, but wouldn't a simple t-shirt still highlight her boobs? Even so, not finding a girl attractive until she starts flaunting her curves only makes sense if she has an ugly face. So why did they cast Jennifer in this role? In fact, a year later, she starred in a movie where she played a character that's not that different from Brooke. At least make her wear glasses or something. Anyway, let's continue with the plot because I can't hardly wait for it to be over.
You! I thought I told you, no free ride!
You can bring the right feet, I got money!
Hey! Hey! I'm an idiot!
Jesus! Do none of the other passengers care about what the driver is doing to Brad?
Stop the bus!
For 65 cents!
Hey, look here, pal!
I got your 65 cents, I want your stinking free ride, buddy! Believe me, Mr. Man, I had to work my slacker body damn side harder to earn this money than just sit behind the steering wheel on my lazy psychotic ass!
Well, that's all I wanted.
Oh, Seth! Josh, what do you guys know about Latin women?
Ah, I know Latin women.
Hola. Mamacita.
Oh, come on! What? Look, I know it's an over-the-top comedy, but this is still too implausible. It was established earlier that Brad had gone to a dangerous area in the city, the kind of location where criminals do whatever they want. So it made sense that these Latinos would chase Brad without even trying to go unnoticed. But now they've gone to another area? Never mind that the trip doesn't seem worth all the trouble. They're crashing a party of high schoolers in the suburbs! Are they not afraid of getting caught? Do they think no one will call the police on them? Even if they tried being more subtle, which they don't, the fact that they've gone to a house full of teenagers is suspicious enough. Oh, and you wanna hear the best part? There is no, I repeat, no resolution for their subplot. They just stop appearing on the screen and viewers just have to assume that nothing bad happened.
Come on, we have some unfinished business. Take me, Brad.
My name's Brad.
not important. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter.
No, no, wait. No. Do you want to tell everybody about her? No. Together.
I'm pretty sure everyone already saw you two going upstairs together.
But I'm going out with Kyle.
Kyle? What is this?
This is your lucky night.
You don't know me.
So? It's just sex.
This character is a big contradiction. At the beginning, she said that she wanted to be swept off her feet.
And now she has done a 180 turns in just a few hours.
When I finally do this, I want it to be absolutely perfect. I want it to be with someone who knows me. Somebody who's like your best friend in the world, you know? Somebody like...
Listen, you probably think that we nitpick a lot, that the mistakes we've mentioned so far are not that bad. And if you want to make that argument, fine, but now we're getting into new territory. Because this is it, guys. This is the scene that proves, truly, why the movie doesn't work. The intention was to tell a story about a boy who thinks he's in love with a girl without realizing that it's just physical attraction. When in reality, it's a story about a boy who wanted to have sex as soon as possible while claiming that it was true love.
What's the difference?
The difference is that Brad is a horn dog who's given the dialogue of a hopeless romantic. The way his friends talk about him makes me roll my eyes.
Brad's a stand-up guy. You know, Brad's your butt. Brad's, you know...
Your best friend.
Exactly. Brad's your best friend, see?
Also, when Brad was practicing his speech with Leah, we saw that he was planning on putting his hand on Brooke's leg before even kissing her. Something you normally do when sex is your main priority. And speaking of Leah, the idea is that she pines over Brad because she sees how charming he really is, and she's willing to wait for him to mature and learn to decipher his own complex emotions. However, whenever these two talk on screen, he comes off as a dick! And now he understands that losing his virginity should be special? This is a conclusion that he reached all by himself. This movie is so phony.
I have been looking for something all night long. And it has caused me nothing but heartache and pain.
Pain? Pain? Bitch, please! Got back up!
But that's only because I was looking for the wrong thing. I should have been looking for you.
And the movie finishes. I must say that this is a kind of movie of a Sunday afternoon where there's nothing else to watch. Many things happen that's out of convenience for the plot, which is a problem because even absurd comedies need some level of consistency. That being said, I laugh from time to time. It reminds me of The Hangover because the protagonist goes one problem to the other and it feels like it will never end. I prefer this over the excessive gross out humor from similar movies, for example American Pie.
I disagree. I found the humor to be very desperate. For God's sakes, there's not one but two gags involving a crotch injury. That being said, I have to give the movie credit. Usually in stories like this, the protagonist doesn't realize that the right person was in front of them all along without a love confession first. But here, Brad realizes how he feels about Leah all by himself. This does not feel phony, actually. And despite all my issues with the character, Will still manages to pull off the lovable loser routine. And Jennifer can play angry and bitter convincingly. Thanks to her talent, it feels a little less unbelievable that someone who looks like that would be treated like an undesirable nerd.
I give it 2 stars out of 5.
And I give it 1 star. Tyrone, thanks for coming.
Thank you for inviting me. Please, go to my channel El Rincón de Tyrone. I don't just review movies, but also retro games, and I do interviews and podcasts. I know that you will enjoy it. Goodbye!
That's it for now. Please subscribe, join my Patreon, and I'll see you later.